So few months back, I brought my first external hard drive, and after using it for a few days, I discovered a strange problem. For instance, these hard drives were working fine on my Windows computer, but on Mac, it became read-only. That is, I was not able to copy data from my Mac to these external hard drives. And similarly, things didn't go well on Android as well as Linux operating system. Now, before buying one of these, I was using these pen drives, which work right out of the box for any operating system. But as you can see, this is clearly not the case with these external hard drives. So why is that, and what can we do to solve it? Hi there, this is Minar once again, and welcome to RTD Videocast. In today's video, we are going to solve two problems. Number one, if you have got these external hard drives and like me, you are facing incompatibility issue. Or second, if you have ever heard the terms like NTFS, FAT32, HFS+, but don't exactly know what it means, then after watching this video, you will have a crystal clear idea of what they are and when to use what. Now, before we jump into the rabbit hole and start looking for the solution, it does make sense to understand the problem first, right? So what is the problem? Well, the file system. Let's assume your file system as a college library and the book inside that as data. Now, every operating system has a different library. That is, they have their own way of arranging their data. For instance, Windows call it NTFS, Mac calls it HFS+, in Linux we have Extend4, and there are a few others like FAT32 or XFAT. Now imagine, if both your computer and your external hard drive has a different file system, then when you will bring them together, obviously they will going to have clashes when reading writing the data back and forth. And this is exactly what is happening here. So now that we know the problem, let's start looking for the solution. Okay, so to get this thing working, we will use this compatibility table to understand the various aspects of file system. However, before that, please understand that this is an explanatory video. Here I will be talking more about the concept than the actual process. So all the how-to part will be included in the separate blog post, and be sure to check out in the link in the description and in the YouTube cards. And that being said, let's get started. Starting with the NTFS format, or the new technology file system. It is mostly used in all the Windows computers right now, and it was first introduced in Windows NT, thus the name NTFS. Now, since Windows still dominate the desktop operating system, it does make sense for the hard drive manufacturer to bundle their drives with NTFS format. So usually people use their external hard drives on Windows and they never face any problem. But sadly, NTFS volumes are read-only on Mac. However, there are three workarounds that will help you. First, you can use programs like NTFS 3G. The good thing about that, it's free and works fine. Even in my past few months of usage, I never had any problem. But the bad part is that this software is out of development, so there is no support. Now, if you want support and reliability, then you will have to empty your pockets and get a paid version from Paragon. And the third option we have is to turn on read and write support from the Mac terminal. Yes, the Mac also supports NTFS file format. However, this method is not recommended by Apple, and the people who have tried it reported that they face problem, especially when they upgrade their operating system. So I won't really recommend this one. Similarly, you can also use your NTFS volume on Linux by using NTFS 3G. Again, Android do not recognize NTFS volume. So to fix that, you can use free apps from Paragon NTFS or Stick Mount, which is available on Google Play. However, Android is still gray area when it comes to NTFS support. So I have prepared a detailed article on my blog post, so be sure to check that out. Overall, NTFS is best file system if you're going to use it on Windows. It supports all the modern features like compression, file system, encryption, and journaling. Now we don't have to go all technical to understand these terms, but in a nutshell, these features are really important, especially on a long run. For instance, say at some point you decided to encrypt your external hard drive. For that, you will need your file system to support encryption. Similarly, if there is no journaling, then there are more chances of data corruption on your hard drive. However, on the other hand, NTFS is not compatible for other operating systems, which is really a bad thing. But you can always get it work with available software, so it's not that bad. coming down to HFS Plus. So HFS is developed by Apple and they are using it as a default file system in Mac and iOS devices. So as long as you are using an HFS formatted hard drive, you can easily use it on Mac. Both read and write supports are present. Now the important thing is, some manufacturers sell HFS formatted hard drive at more price than the NTFS counterpart. Just because you know everything is expensive in Macs, so just raise the price and no one will notice. However, if you are looking for a hard drive for your Mac, then you can buy anyone and then format it yourself. There is no need to pay extra. Now, if you want to use HFS format drives on Windows, then you can use free softwares like HFS Explorer. But even with that, you will only be able to read it content. Now, if you want to do both read and write, then you can always buy a Paragon HFS Explorer and do that. However, since Mac is derived from Unix, you can easily read HFS volume on Linux operating system. And if you also want to get the write access, then simply turn off journaling in HFS format. Now if you want to use your HFS drive on Android, then you can use free apps from Paragon, just like we did in the NTFS part. I will also leave the Google Play link in the description. Now the good thing about HFS is, if you're only going to use this hard drive on your Mac, then the file system is highly recommended. It has all the modern features and will keep your device healthy in long run. However, using it on other operating system is real pain, especially if you're going to use it on Windows. Now I know there are workarounds, but they are not practical in long run. For instance, if you're using HFS Explorer on Windows, then you will also have to install Java, and even after that you're going to get read access, which is kind of bad. Next up is FAT32, short for file allocation table. So it is the oldest of all the file system. Remember I told you NTFS was first introduced with Windows NT? Well, before that FAT was used. And even after 3 decades, we are still using FAT32. Why? Well, this is because this file system is entirely compatible with every operating system. Yes, this means if you format your hard drive with FAT32, then you can use it on Windows, Mac, Linux, and even on television set, MP3 player, and PS3. Now, I know what you're thinking. If FAT32 is so good, then why not just format it with FAT32 and that will be it? Well, not so fast. There are other few major problems with FAT32. Since it is an old file system, it lacks all the major features like compression, encryption, and journaling. So there is no user protection here, and there are more chances of bad sector. Moreover, the maximum single file size is only 4GB. This means if you have a Blu-ray movie of 5GB, then you cannot put it inside a FAT32 formatted hard drive. Now, I know I didn't mention this file size limit in any other file system. This is because all the others have the limit in terabytes or exabytes, which is way too much, at least for now. So overall, FAT32 is suitable for small flash drive and SSD, but for external hard drive, it's not really ideal. And finally, XFAT, which is a relatively new file system and was introduced just a decade ago. So XFAT is short for Extended FAT and does exactly what its name suggests. It extends the functionality of FAT. Like FAT, XFAT also works with all the operating system, well, kind of. For instance, XFAT work right off the box with Windows and Mac, but you can also get it work with Linux by using the free package called XFAT Fuse. And for Android, you guess it, the same Paragon app, right? Well, no. Even though this app claims to work with XFAT, it actually don't work. But why? We will see that in later part of this video. But in the meanwhile, you can always use Stick Mount app and get it working. Also, XFAT supports file size up to 16 exabyte, which is lot and better than FAT32. So what is the catch here? Well, to start with, it still misses the important features like journaling and file compression, thus making it not really ideal for the external hard drive. And second, like NTFS and HFS, XFAT is also a proprietary file system, which means if other manufacturers are using XFAT, then they will have to pay a small royalty to Microsoft, thus making it not really ideal in open source environment like Linux and Android. However, XFAT is a popular format for SD card of high-end video cameras that shoots 4K video. Why? Well, because you can hold single file greater than 4GB, which was not possible in FAT32. Okay, so here is the TLDR version. Number 1, if you want to use your external hard drive mostly on Windows computer and sometimes on Mac, Linux and Android, then use the NTFS format. And whenever you want to use it with other operating system, you can simply use NTFS 3G and free software from Paragon. Number 2, If you want to use your external hard drive mostly on Mac operating system and very rarely on other operating system, then go with HFS Plus. However, do note when you want to use it with other operating system, especially Windows, then it will be much tougher. Number third, if you're going to use your external hard drive on every platform, which includes Windows, Mac, Linux, even your television and PS3, then use FAT32. It is compatible everywhere. But on the flip side, you will have to compromise with modern features like encryption and journaling, and you will also be restricted to 4GB file size limit. And fourth, if you're going to use this external hard drive equally on Windows and Mac, then XFAT is the best format. Trust me, I have used it for months and it works like a charm. Well, this is all for now. This was my first attempt with explanatory videos. So if you find that video useful and want to see more of them in future, then let me know in the comment section below. Also, a lot of research and testing has went into this video. So I would really appreciate if you give this video a thumbs up. And with that being said, subscribe to this channel for more awesome videos in future. Till then, it is Minal signing off, and like always, thanks for watching.